Hello, my little Bundy buddies. Bundy's Garage, Bundy here. Hey, today we're working on a 1988 Toyota Corolla with a 1.6 liter. You also find this on a Chevy Nova with the same engine. This engine actually has a timing belt, so just take note of that if you haven't done the timing belt on this thing. But we're actually changing out the distributor, and I just showed you right there. Just marked all the four plugs with markings, so I knew exactly how to put it back on. Took a picture of it with my cell phone after I got done marking them, just so when it came time to put everything back, I knew exactly where they went. I'm actually taking off the front cover there. It's 3 8-millimeter bolts that hold this thing on, screws. You need a ratchet, a quarter-inch ratchet, and an 8-millimeter socket. Then you need an 8-millimeter wrench as well. Now I'm reaching down there, getting all the vacuum lines out. You can also take a picture of that just so you know how the vacuum lines go back on when it's time to reinstall it. Taking off that front cover, and the reason I did that is because there's a 12-millimeter bolt on the back side that you can't see. So if you're facing it, it'd be on the bottom left. There's a 12-millimeter bolt you have to remove, and it just made it a little bit easier to gain access to that bolt with that front cover off of the distributor. I'm just checking to make sure all the vacuum lines are off. This was not hard at all, really. Very, very easy. So right there you can see the bolt. I have my hand on it right there. I had already loosened it up, so I'm just pulling it out. There's only one bolt that holds it in, holds the distributor in. And I'm just grabbing it and pulling it straight out towards me. Then I have the electrical connector there that I forgot to unplug. So that's pretty easy. You just pull up on a tab and you separate the green part from the black part. And it's free and clear. Now the weird thing about this is that this car keeps eating distributors for whatever reason. This Toyota Corolla with a 1.6 liter keeps eating distributors. If you guys have any suggestions why it does or why it is happening, you leave a comment below and let me know what you think. I'm kind of thinking leaning towards the alternator. Maybe the alternator is going bad and shooting a surge through the electrical system, wiping it out. So there's the bolt, the 12-millimeter bolt. I just put it back into the engine block while I was waiting for the new distributor to come in. Now I'm just taking some old engine oil, putting it on the new O-ring for the distributor. You want to make sure that's coated with oil or grease or something so it goes in nice and easy, slides in nice and easy. You don't want that O-ring to roll over on itself and then you'll have a major oil leak. So it just kind of clicks into place. If you want, you can clock the distributor with the old one. What I mean by that is mark a place on the engine block and mark the distributor. And then when you get the new distributor, you can transfer that mark from the old distributor to the new one. And then line up your mark on the engine block just so you know exactly where it came out. Coming up, you have to... that 12-millimeter bolt is the way you adjust the timing on the engine. So if the bolt is loose, you can actually move the distributor clockwise or counterclockwise. And just depending on where you need it to be, see right there, I'm moving it. And just depending on where you need it to be on timing is where you will actually end up locking the bolt down into. So there you can see I'm putting the bolt in. But for me, it's more of a feel and a sound kind of thing. I just let the engine warm up. And then depending on how high I want the RPM is when I'll start adjusting the distributor. See, I'm moving it right there. And then once I find out that sweet spot, that's when I'll go ahead and I'll lock the bolt down. So here I'm just putting in, I had to remove one of the spark plug wires to get access to the 12 millimeter bolt. So I'm just taking that and putting that back into place. Putting all four spark plug wires back in the distributor based on my markings. All the vacuum lines are in. Have to put in the connector near the bottom. I'm just reaching in there right now and making sure that 12-millimeter bolt is all the way seated. It's not tight, it's just hand tight. And then I'm trying to start the vehicle. The battery is too dead to start the vehicle, so I actually had to get my vehicle some jumper cables to be able to start it. Just bringing my jumper cables right here. And then I started. The way I figured out the distributor was bad, the owner would sit in the car and I'd actually pull off a spark plug, wire off one of the spark plugs, and as he cranked it, I'd watch for a spark between the spark plug wire and the spark plug, and I didn't see any spark, so I knew the distributor was bad. So here I ended up starting the vehicle. I know it's kind of loud, but I just wanted you guys to hear it a little bit. If you can, subscribe to my channel. Thanks, everybody. I hit 25,000 subscribers, and looking for the next 25,000 as well. And here in the final scene, I just go ahead. The engine's warm. I'm just going in there, making the final adjustment based on sound. Then I come in with a 12-millimeter wrench to lock the bolt down. Looking back, I don't think I would have needed to take off the that front cover, the 3 8-millimeter bolts. All I'd have to do is reach in there like that from the passenger side with a 12-millimeter wrench and get that bolt loose, and I think the whole thing would have come off after I got the vacuum lines and the electrical connector and spark plug wires off of it. So there you go, guys. If you're working on a 1988 Toyota Corolla with a 1.6 liter, it's a 30-year-old car, but if you need to change out the distributor, that is how you do it. Very, very easy. Anybody could do this. Not hard at all. So there you go, guys.